is now. ഒരു കാര്യം പ്രത്യേകമായിട്ട് പറയുവാൻ എനിക്ക് സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്. ബേബിയുടെ വിവാഹം ബഹുമാനപ്പെട്ട വികാരി അച്ഛൻ്റെ അനുവാദത്തോടും ബഹുമാനപ്പെട്ട ഷിബു ഡാനിയൽ അച്ഛൻ്റെ സാന്നിധ്യത്തിലും നിങ്ങളുടെ ഓരോരുത്തരുടെയും സാന്നിധ്യത്തിലും നടത്തുന്നതിൽ പ്രത്യേകമായിട്ട് സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്. എൻ്റെ സന്തോഷത്തിന് കുറച്ചുകൂടെ ഒരു പൂർണ്ണത വരുന്നത് ഈ ദേവാലയത്തിൽ വെച്ച് നടത്തുന്ന ആദ്യത്തെ വിവാഹം എന്ന നിലയിലും വിശുദ്ധ മോറോൻ കൂദാശ നടത്തിയിട്ടുള്ള പരിശുദ്ധ ദേവാലയത്തിൽ വെച്ച് നമ്മുടെ വിവാഹങ്ങൾ നടത്തുവാൻ സാധിക്കുന്നു എന്നുള്ളത് വലിയൊരു ദൈവാനുഗ്രഹമായിട്ടും കാണുകയാണ്. തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും ഈ വിവാഹം അനുഗ്രഹകരമായി തീരുവാൻ തക്കവണ്ണവും ഇവരുടെ കുടുംബജീവിതം അനുഗ്രഹകരമായി തീരുവാൻ തക്കവണ്ണവും നമുക്ക് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാം. ദൈവം തമ്പുരാൻ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കട്ടെ.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one true God.
Glory be to Him, and may His grace and mercy upon us forever. Amen.
Holy, 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 O God Almighty, by whose glory the heaven and the earth are filled. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is He who has come, has come,
and is to come. In the name of the Lord God, glory be to Him in the highest.
Holy art Thou, O God.
Holy art Thou, Almighty. Holy art Thou, Immortal. Crucified for us, have mercy upon us.
Holy art Thou, O God.
Holy art Thou, Almighty. Holy art Thou, Immortal. Crucified for us, have mercy upon us.
Holy art Thou, O God.
Holy art Thou, Almighty. Holy art Thou, Immortal. Crucified for us, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, be kind and have mercy. Lord, accept our prayers and entreaties, and have mercy on us.
Glory be to Thee, O God.
Glory be to Thee, O Creator. Glory be to Thee, O Christ, our King, who does pity sinners, Thy servants spot and moan.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace.
Our Lord is with Thee. Blessed are You among women, and blessed is the fruit of Thy womb, our Lord Jesus Christ. O Virgin Saint Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
May His grace and mercy be upon us, weak and sinful servants, in this world and the world to come. Amen.
O Lord God, make us worthy of Your everlasting joy. May the beginning and the end of our happiness be with You and in You. May our souls and spirit rejoice in You. Cast away far from us, by Your mercy, all our suffering. Make our virtue to be increased by Your kindness. May our thoughts be enriched. May this groom be made perfect, and this bride will be more perfect with You and with Your holy saints, who have pleased You from the beginning. May we rejoice in Your eternal happiness. O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, offer Your glory and praise to the fellowship of the saints and the communion of Your dear one, ever and always, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Have mercy upon me, O God, according to Thy loving kindness. According to the multitude of Thy tender mercies, blot out my transgression.
Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgressions,
and my sins are ever before me.
Against thee, thee only have I sinned and done evil in thy sight, that thou shalt be justified in thy words and blameless in thy judgment. For I was born in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me.
For thou desire truth in the inner parts, and hast made known to me the mysteries of thy wisdom. Sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow.
Fill me with joy and gladness, let these broken bones rejoice in thee. Turn thy face away from my sins, blot out all my iniquity.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy glorious spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall turn back to you.
Deliver me from thy guiltiness, O God, God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of thy righteousness. O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall sing forth thy praises.
For thou dost not take delight in sacrifice, or I would offer it, and thou art not pleased with burnt offerings. The sacrifices of God are a humble spirit, and a broken and contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise.
Do good unto Zion according to thy good pleasure, and build the walls of Jerusalem. Then thou shalt be pleased with the sacrifices of righteousness, with burnt offerings and whole burnt offerings. And then they shall offer bullocks upon thine altar. Glory be to thee, O Lord, Baruch Mo.
Children who have come closer to each other. O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, unite them now and forever, that they may love and accept each other, so to live cheerfully in union with each other all the days of their lives.
Amen.
And mercy.
Oh, merciful Lord, have mercy upon us and help us.
Make us all worthy, O Lord, to offer up to you continually at all times and in all seasons praise and thanksgiving, glory and honor and unceasing exaltation. Glory be to the heavenly bridegroom who has chosen the daughter of the Gentiles, as the church for himself has cleansed her by his victorious blood from all sins and iniquities, who has betrothed to himself the church of this world, and himself becoming bridegroom to her, has set her free from all her debts and sins. Blessed be the Lord who has invited to the wedding feast of his church the Gentiles and his own people, the prophets and the apostles, and all races. To him be glory, honor, and worship at this time of the blessings of the rings, of his servants at all festivals and times and hours, and seasons and all the days of our life. Bugul hunyomo sodhain level me.
Amen.
Barakmore, O God, you are transcendent and exalted above all human understanding, unceasingly abundant in mercy, in whom is the fullness of all goodness forever, who is away from all evils and from whom all divine blessings originate. You are without beginning and end, the incorruptible holy chrism, and eternally exalted above all sufferings and death. You adorned your creation, magnified it, and assisted it with your loving kindness, and according to its power strengthened and received its faith in you. You gave to your holy church your incorruptible blessings, endowed her with your sweet fragrance, and enriched her with the glorious garments. You betrothed her with water and spirit, and made her your bride. You bruised the head of the enemy with your might, gave her the pure gift of your victorious body and blood, which is the ring. You made her rejoice and gloriously illumine her with the brightness of your light. You gave her divine blessings and made her to abide with you forever. Through the holy apostles you established her in order and perfected her. You decided to perfect the joy of the husband and wife through the ring, and brought to perfection and the happiness of the betrothed. O Lord God, bless now these rings with delight which we, your unworthy servants, have blessed. We beseech you so to bless these rings, that they which were accursed may be your mercy, be sanctified, and be made holy. O Lord God, bless these rings with your divine blessings as you have blessed the rings of your holy church. O Lord God, perfect this groom, our son, and this bride, our daughter, that they may become full and perfect in heavenly wisdom. O Lord, by your abundant grace, keep their marriage far from all impurity and wickedness. O Lord God, make them incessantly cheerful both in this world and in the world to come, and adorn them with chastity all the days of their life in this transient bridal chamber. Have mercy on them and let them enter with joy into your heavenly bridal chamber, where angels and seraphim rejoice continuously forever and ever. And O Lord, by your love, keep this congregation who stands before you free from all sins and wickedness, impurities and trespasses. May your blessings be bestowed upon them, that they may bless and praise you, your Father, and your Holy Spirit, unceasingly standing before you with endless joy, now and forever. Hosho Wabukula Suban Level Me
Amen.
Barak more from God may we receive remission of sins and forgiveness of debts in both worlds forever and ever.
Amen. Padirudaya paripavana sabai vano kandam ve parune Shibhojo ennalin nivari avaram che ven pichevam veedin paranam shibhoni suvise shamjo
sweet fragrance of virtues may rise up from them. May true love, peace, concord, and inseparable unity reign between them. Help them, O Lord, to keep pure for each other, both in spirit and in body, and offer up praise and glory to you, our always for ever and ever.
Amen.
തന്റെ കരുണയാലും ബഹുലമായ കൃപയാലും ഈ
ഈ മോചനങ്ങളെ ആശീർവദിക്കുന്ന പിതാവിനും പുത്രനും പരിശുദ്ധ രൂഹായിക്കും സ്തുതി. വിശുദ്ധ സഭാ സന്താനങ്ങളുടെ സന്തോഷപൂർത്തിക്കായി പിതാവിൻ്റെയും പുത്രൻ്റെയും ചെയ്യുന്ന പരിശുദ്ധ രൂഹായുടെയും നാമത്തിൽ ഈ മോചനങ്ങൾ ആശീർവദിക്കപ്പെട്ടിരിക്കുന്നു.
May the right hand of our Lord Jesus Christ be mercifully stretched out to you, together with this visible ring of betrothal. May you receive his invisible grace and mercy. May his right hand, which is full of mercy that showers blessings, be with you and protect you all the days of your life.
Amen.
The right hand of our Lord Jesus Christ be mercifully stretched out to you. May you receive this ring of your betrothal from the hands of this priest as if from the hands of holy apostle. With peacefulness of soul and body and with joy of heart, may you offer praise to the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit, both now and always and forever and ever.
May the Lord, who has perfected the joy of His holy church through His Messiah, perfect these our children who have been betrothed to each other with truth and righteousness. May He grant them heavenly blessings along with these rings which they have received. May He adorn them with chastity and exalt them with meekness. May He perfect their betrothal with the rings of righteousness, as He perfected the betrothal of Isaac and Rebekah with golden ornaments. May this bridegroom rejoice with joy in His great salvation, and may this bride be adorned with imperishable and incorruptible beauty. May He seal her with the beauty of purity, which is more excellent than the beauty of jewels or gold. May God make their union and their coming together to be pleasing to Him and for the growth of worthy character in them. May He keep them away from all hypocritical love and kindle their hearts with the fire of love, that they may love each other. May He adorn them with imperishable beauty. May He grant them grace to govern all their thoughts with pure chastity, which far excels the fragrance of roses. May God save them from the hands of evil and envious men who hate their fellow men. May He keep them safe from evil spirits who corrupt the purity of the most holy marriage. May the Lord grant them from His abode seasons of goodness and years of blessings. Hearken, O Lord God, to the supplications of us, your weak and sinful servants, who stand before your majesty. Grant them the gift of blessed children and seasons of joy. Enrich them with the true riches of good deeds. Confirm them in the true faith in you. May they remain in the true faith, and let their children also inherit the same. Multiply your blessings and your goodness on those who have come here for this celebration. Guard this bridegroom and this bride by your victorious cross. O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, shower upon us all your abundant mercies, now and always, forever and ever. Hosho vabukulis man laval me.
Thank you.
For this act of witness which has been sanctified by God, may God reward you 30, 60 and 100-fold. May He reward you with good things at all times. May the cross of our Lord be with you by night and by day, and keep you safe from the evil one and his host. Hoshua b'kulus ban Lord me.
Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, one true God. Amen. Most respected Achans, dear Arun and Smita, dearly beloved in Christ, first of all, let me express my joy and gratitude to Arun and Smita for inviting me to this wedding, and Achans for giving me this opportunity to speak a few words on this blessed occasion of the Holy Marriage. Today is one of the most important days in Arun and Smita's life. As we all know, there's always a sense of excitement in the air, and particularly on the part of bride and groom on the day of their wedding. Also, I would say it is perfect time for every one of us who are married to reflect upon our lives and see if we are fulfilling the responsibilities that we have made with God and with our spouse. That's why I said it's a blessed day and it's a perfect opportunity for every one of us. Dear Arun and Smita, we as Christians, particularly we as Orthodox Christians, we establish marriage as a divine plan and a holy sacrament that God bless and authorize. According to the understanding and teaching of the Holy Church, marriage is a sacrament of love. The snehathinte kudashi ennaanu. It is a sacrament of love. It's a divine love that overrules all selfish love. And it is established by God Himself. That is our understanding. And also we hear from the service of the Holy Matrimony a beautiful prayer there. A beautiful prayer is there. It says, may God remove from them every insincere love and kindle their minds with the fire of love that they shall love each other. മലയാളത്തിലെ ആ പ്രാർത്ഥന ഇപ്രകാരമാണ്, ദൈവമായ കർത്താവ് സകല കപട സ്നേഹത്തെയും ഇവരിൽ നിന്ന് നീക്കിക്കളയുകയും അന്യോന്യം സ്നേഹിപ്പാനായി സ്നേഹാഗ്നി കൊണ്ട് ഇവരുടെ ഹൃദയങ്ങളെ ഉജ്ജ്വലിപ്പിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യട്ടെ. സച്ച് എ ബ്യൂട്ടിഫുൾ പ്രയർ ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് എ ഡിവൈൻ സാക്രമെൻറ്റ്. ബട്ട് ആസ് യു ഓൾ നോ, അൺഫോർച്ചുനേറ്റ്ലി വി ഓൾ ലിവ് ഇൻ എ വേൾഡ് ടുഡേ വെയർ മാരേജ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് ടേക്കൻ സീരിയസ്ലി ഓർ മെയിൻറ്റെയിൻ ഇറ്റ് പ്രോപ്പർലി. ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ്സ് സാഡ് ദാറ്റ് മെനി പീപ്പിൾ ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് മാരേജ് ആസ് എ സിമ്പിൾ കോൺട്രാക്ട് ബിറ്റ്വീൻ ടു ഇൻഡിവിജ്വൽസ് ഫോർ ലീഗൽ പർപ്പസസ് or sometimes just for living together and never truly see it as a divine institution of God. When you look at the Bible, we see it was God who noted our need for each other, our need for one another. The scripture says it is not good for the man to be alone. മനുഷ്യനെ ഏകനായിരിക്കുന്നത് നന്നല്ല. So it's a divine plan. It is a divine institution. And we all are here today to bless this occasion, to pray for them. And I would say God created Adam. We all know that, and he entrusted him into the Garden of Eden. I said the scripture itself says it is not good for the man to be alone. I'm not talking about just being alone. We all know that we can be in the midst of hundreds and thousands of people and still be very lonely, right? Yes. Look at Adam. God created Adam and he put him in the Garden of Eden. Still he was lonely. He had all the animals. He even had God with him. Still God realized, even then God realized that something was missing in Adam's life. He did not have an intimate human companionship. Because God created Adam with a constant inclination to God and with a need for an intimate human companionship. God's solution for loneliness is companionship, and God's model of companionship is marriage. And also we see, be united and become one flesh. Avar iruvarum oru shariramayittu. That means they both are committed to each other. Husband and wife are incomplete without each other. That's what it means. I don't know, you will be incomplete without Smita. And the same way, Smita, you'll be incomplete without Arun from now onwards. God says, I will make a suitable companion for him. God never said, I will make a suitable lover for him, or a provider for him, or a mother for his children, or a servant for all his needs. God said, I will make a suitable companion for him. Takka tuna. I will make a suitable companion for him so that when life becomes too difficult for one to handle, the suitable companion will be there to help. When one person is in a disappointed, in a hopeless situation, the other person can breathe words of hope. When one person is unhappy and sad, the other person can bring joy and happiness. That's what I said. It is two people coming together, supporting and helping each other to survive and make it through. Of course, there will be, as we all know, there will be disagreements, quarrels, fights, and even sometimes we have differences of opinion. But always think that it is your responsibility to maintain this relationship as divine and maintain this sacrament in Christian, high Christian quality. That's what a Christian marriage is all about. Let me conclude my words. Today, Arun and Smita, you are here in this beautiful temple of God, in the presence of this humble and reverent priest, in front of the holy altar, and ultimately in the presence of your Father in heaven. You both are going to take up a great responsibility, a great decision. Be serious about the decision you both are going to take up today. And always remember, there are so many people who made both of you come here today. Your parents, your teachers, your family, your friends. Be accountable to them. And ultimately, be accountable to your Father in heaven. So on behalf of the whole congregation assembled here, and on behalf of all Achans, and my personal behalf, I wish you both a very blessed Christian family married life. Thank you, and God bless you both.
And let us all stand. The second part of the service, the blessings of the crowns.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and Holy Spirit.
May His grace and mercy be upon us, weak and sinful servants, in this world and the world to come. Amen.
O Lord God, make us worthy of endless feast and the imperishable bridal chamber. Invite us, O Lord, to your eternal joys, along with the invitees of that feast. And to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we will offer up glory and praise now and always forever and ever.
Amen. I do the body. Ked moi avel bari
ina sere varta te deva te chidi lelame
au veda da mine vartiya devam tan behu krubaya
Deva,
united to each other through the riches of your gifts. Make them rejoice in your bounty. Fill them with the delight which flows from the keeping of your holy commandments. O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, may they be full of joy in your presence and glorify you. Hosho Vabukula Suban Lavalmi.
Exaltation unceasing, truly at all times and hours, may we escape unto thee, O Lord. Glory be to the eternal Word, the self-existent One, who was and who is and who shall be for all generations, who is worshipped by the angels surrounding his throne, who, though he is high and exalted, by his abundant mercy, has compassion for all, and who has brought our race back to him. By his love, he has made our nation, which has strayed from him, worthy to be brought near to him. He cannot be known or comprehended by all the philosophers and theologians, save that all may worship him. Worship his self-existence. He fashions the crown of rulers. He loosens that which no one can be bind, and binds that which no one can be loosened. He gives crowns for joy to the bridegrooms and the bride for the glory of his majesty. He is worthy of glory, honor at this time, of blessings of the crowns of his servant, at all festivals, hours and seasons, all the days of our life.
Amen.
O Lord God, whom all the heavenly hosts glorify with fear and trembling, and before whose majesty the multitudes of celestial things in higher heaven trembles, you in your abounding and ineffable mercy and your limitless kindness, do rejoice in your weak and feeble praises. You delight in your praises, weak and earthly beings though we are. You do encourage us to ask from you that which we are in need of. You are quick to bestow your gifts. You are long suffering and slow to punish even those who deserve punishment. O Lord, bless these your servants, Aruna and Smita, who dwell under the shelter of your majesty, under the shadow of your wings of your loving kindness, in all places, and whosoever they may go, keep them in health and safety and joy, that they may be full of blessings in their deeds. Keep them safe and guide them in the path of your commandments, that they may walk in your truth. Grant them grace, that they may run the straight course that leads to the heavenly kingdom. May they become rich in spiritual grace and in divine gift, which profit both body and soul. And may they lay up for themselves treasure in heaven. O Lord, enable them to love eternal life and keep them far from deadly sin. Unite in their hearts, that they may never draw near to you and avoid the bondage of Satan and the cursed. Help us to labor righteously in your spiritual vineyard and observe your holy commandments. O Lord, make us of one heart with the congregation of your saints, of those who love each other and hate evil, and those who obey your divine majesty and who bless their enemies. O Lord, enable us to be worshippers well pleasing to your majesty. O Lord God, comfort our faithful departed ones and give them joy in your heavenly kingdom. O Lord, you are good and lover of mankind. We offer glory and thanks to you and to your Father and the Holy Spirit, now always, for ever and ever.
Amen.
For God made the remission of the dead and forgiveness of the sins, both works for ever and ever.
സുന്ദരികളിലതി സുന്ദരി നീചാരികളിൽ സൂനു ദ്രുപതി ശതമാൻ വിമല സഭേ നിന്നേലാളിപ്പുനരങ്ങൾ മധുവർഷിക്കുന്നു വസന സുഗന്ധം നീസാൽ കുസുമസമം സഭേ സകലവിധം സുമുഖി നീ കരതീണ്ടാത്തോ ശ്രീമായി വന്നിപ്പതിന രാജാവാമശിഹ ഹല്ലേലൂയാ കാക്കും ജഗനം ദുഷ്ടാത്മാവിൻ ഉള്ളിൽ പോകീടാ ചവയാ അന്യോന്യം മൂലം കോട്ടകളിടയിൽ സ്ഥലമില്ലി പാതസുതാമരൂഹായ ഏക
പട്ടണത്തിൽ കല്യാണം വരുന്നതിനായി ക്ഷണിക്കപ്പെടുകയും വെള്ളത്തെ മേൽത്തരും വീഞ്ഞായി മാറ്റുകയും ചെയ്ത മനുഷ്യസ്നേഹിയും സാക്ഷാൽ സത്യമണവാളനുമായ കർത്താവേ, ഇപ്പോൾ നിന്റെ വിശുദ്ധ ബലിപീഠത്തിന് മുൻപാകെ തലകുനിച്ച് നിൽക്കുന്ന ഈ ദാസരെ ഈ സുഗന്ധ ധൂപം അംഗീകരിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ. കരുണയും ദയവും നിറഞ്ഞതായ അതിൻ്റെ വലത്തുകൈ ഇവരുടെ മേൽ ആവസിപ്പിക്കണമേ. ആത്മീയമായ നിന്റെ മണവറയിൽ ഇവരെ സന്തോഷിപ്പിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യണമേ. നിന്നെ സ്നേഹിക്കുകയും നിന്റെ കൽപ്പനകൾ ആചരിക്കുകയും ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ളവരായ വിശുദ്ധന്മാർക്ക് വാഗ്ദാനം ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ള വിരുന്നിന് ഞങ്ങളെയും ഇവരെയും യോഗ്യരാക്കുകയും ചെയ്യണമേ. ഞങ്ങളും ഇവരും നിനക്കും നിന്റെ വലതുഭാഗത്ത് നിന്നുകൊണ്ട് നിന്റെ കരുണയെ ദർശിക്കുകയും നിനക്കും നിന്റെ പിതാവിനും നിന്റെ പരിശുദ്ധ രൂപായിക്കും സ്തുതിയും സ്തോത്രവും കരയറ്റുകയും ചെയ്യുമാറാകണമേ.
Ephesians chapter 5 verse 20 through chapter 6 verse 3. Barakimor, always give thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Submit yourself one to another in the love of Christ. Wives, submit yourself to your husband as to our Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife. Just as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Therefore, as this church is subject to Christ, so let the wives be to their own husband in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse by washing of water and by the word, in order to build for himself a glorious church without stain or wrinkle or any such, but that it should be holy without blemish. So should men love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no man ever yet hated his own body, but nourishes it and cherishes it, just as Christ does for his church. For this reason shall a man leave his father and mother and shall be joined to his wife, and the two shall be one flesh. This is the greatest mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and his church. Nevertheless, let every one of you so love his wife as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is the right thing to do. Honor your father and mother. This is the commandment. This is the first commandment with the promise, so that all may go well with you and you may live long on this earth. Ahai Barakimor.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Bodhikatte param,
Barghumor Shlomo Lekulkun.
May the Lord make us worthy and with thy spirit.
Evangelion Gadishud Moranishmashigo Gorususo Mahunisu Minmataisligo Agrasano Dmagresa Hai Furuko Nulmo.
Blessed is he who has come and is to come in the name of the Lord. Praise be to him who sent him for our salvation, and may his blessings be upon us all forever.
Sabinho Gilgam Tabruzno Sid Moran Varugan Varugudilanishmashigo Melsodhayu Alugodaspasar Melsuddho Kadistu Mariam. Holy then ho khanu vai.
We believe and confess.
The Gospel according to Saint Matthew, chapter 19, verses 1 to 12. When Jesus had finished this saying, he departed from Galilee and came into the coast of Judea beyond Jordan. A great multitude followed him, and he healed them there. Some Pharisees came up to him and tempted him, saying, is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any reason? But he answered them, saying, have you not read that he who made at the beginning made them male and female? And he said, because of this reason, man shall leave his father and his mother, and shall be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. They are no longer two, but one. But therefore God has joined together, let no man separate. They said to him, why then did Moses command one to give certificate of divorce and to put her away? He said to them, for your hardness of heart, Moses allowed you to divorce your wives, but from the beginning it was not so. And I say to you, whoever divorces his wife except for the reason of fornication and marries another commits adultery. The disciples said to him, if such is the case of a man and his wife, it is not expedient to marry. But he said to them, not all men can receive this saying, but only those to whom it is given. For there are eunuchs who have been so from birth, and there are eunuchs who have been made so by men, and there are those who have made themselves eunuchs for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. He who is able to receive this, let him receive it. Peace be unto you all. പൂർണ്ണമാക്കപ്പെട്ടിരിക്കുന്നു.
വൈദിക ശന്മാർച്ചന്മാലിംബം നൽക മണവാളനയാചാര്യൻ അണിക്കും മകുടം രമ്യം
garments. May he clothe you with the victorious armor that withstands all the power of the enemy. May you rejoice all the days of your life and offer up glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and always and forever and ever.
ശ്രീ ഹോ
Righteousness with incorruptible beauty. May you rejoice all the days of your life and offer up glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, both now and always and forever and ever.
Amen.
Humanity be pleased with your lives and bless your fellowship. May the Messiah, the heavenly bridegroom, seal your marriage with his truth. May you rejoice in each other as the Messiah rejoices in his church. May his right hand of mercy be upon you and abide with you and keep you from all evil. May the angel of peace abide with you and keep you from the evil ways of Satan. May the Lord deliver you from deadly jealousy, unite you to each other, and remove from you all sorrows. May the Lord give you the gift of blessed children, so that you may rejoice as Abraham rejoiced in Isaac, and Isaac in Jacob, and Jacob in Joseph. May God, who blessed Noah and his sons, saying, "Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth," abide with you and bless you. May God, who blessed Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, abide with you and bless you. May God grant you dew from heaven and all good fruits that the earth produces. May the blessing of Jacob that blessed his son Joseph, saying, "The God of your father shall help you," abide with you. May the blessing of those who have loved God and have been well pleasing to him rest upon you and all the and on the crowns that the priests placed on your heads today. Because you are called after the name of the Lord, may all the people of God rejoice and glorify God. May God enrich you with all good things and prosperity, and may He forgive your debts and sins as He forgave the woman who was a sinner. May you inherit His heavenly kingdom, as did the thief who was at His right hand. May all our departed ones receive remission of sins. May the Most High, who came down in Mount Sinai to make a covenant with the bride that came out of Egypt, bless you and our entire congregation. We offer up glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and always, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Beloved brethren, as we all stand in God's holy temple, we have now to remind the faithful of those things which we have received through the ages from the handing down from our holy fathers and reverend forefathers. That is that we have to exhort and firmly command these that stand before us to be watchful and earnest in truth and righteousness and in good deeds. Our children, remember that you are standing before God, the holy altar, which is the throne of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before the cross, before the holy gospel, and before this congregation. It is not before one who is ignorant of the thoughts of your hearts that you stand, but before the one to whom they are all known. Behold, from this time onward, we entrust you, each other, to the other.
Again, dear brother, it known unto you that these commandments are for all of you, how each one of you should behave yourself towards his wife. She has left her own people and he has been joined to her husband. Therefore, he must please her and show kindness to her. He must cherish her as he would cherish his own soul. He must feed and clothe her, even if he has to go without food and clothing. Even if he is thirsty, he must give her to drink. She too must always serve him dutifully and with love and affection. By the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, be with each other and all of us forever and ever. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace,
our Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, our Lord Jesus Christ. O Virgin Saint Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Argimor, attend me to divine wisdom. Let us all stand up well and respond to the reverend priest and say,
even true God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible,
and in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father, before all worlds, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of the same substance with the Father, and by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Virgin Mary, Mother of God, by the Holy Ghost, and became man, and was crucified for us in the days of Pontius Pilate, and suffered and died, and was buried, and the third day rose again, according to his will, and ascended into heaven, and sits on the right hand of the Father, and shall come again in his great glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end.
And in the one living Holy Spirit,
the life-giving Lord of all, who proceeds from the Father, and together with the Father and the Son, is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets and the apostles.
And in the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church,
and we acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and look for the resurrection of the dead, and the new life of the world to come. Amen.
Argimor
stomicalis prelaiso.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oya ninmala mahi raja paminiyo
Ninnara garajan bohipa Alleluia yo Alleluia ne jana bhorka Abhidrugraham varekimho
സംബന്ധിച്ച് നിങ്ങളെല്ലാവരെയും ദൈവം തുമ്പരാൻ വാഴ്ത്തി അനുഗ്രഹിക്കുമാറാകട്ടെ. നിങ്ങളെ വിശ്വാസികളായ നമ്മുടെ വാങ്ങിപ്പോരെ ദൈവം തുമ്പരാൻ ആശ്വസിപ്പിക്കട്ടെ. പിതാവും പുത്രനും പരിശുദ്ധ ദ്രൂഹായുമായുള്ളവേ, ബലഹീനമുള്ളതും കുറവുള്ളതുമായ ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രാർത്ഥനകളും അപേക്ഷകളും അവിടുത്തെ ഉന്നതമായ സിംഹാസനത്തിന് മുൻപാകെ കേൾക്കപ്പെട്ടവയും അംഗീകരിക്കപ്പെട്ടവയുമായി ആക്കി തീർക്കുമാറാകണമേ. ആബോ അവ്രോ റൂഹോ കാദേശോ ഹോശോ വബുക്കുലസ്ബാൻ ലോവൽമീ
ആമേൻ.
Of the wedding ceremony. Now the bridegroom and the bride are going to sign the register.
Good afternoon, everyone. What a beautiful and blessed day this is. Thank you, everyone, for coming here, especially a big thanks to Babu Chin for having us conduct this wedding here at the last moment. Like, you know, we had to make some changes because of some technical issues. But fortunately, like, you know, it was I think I consider this more blessed, like, you know, we are able to conduct it in our own church. And this is a beautiful church. And it's a beautiful church, and both Arun and Smita are so blessed that this is the first wedding in this church. All right, again, a big thanks to Babu Achin. Johnson Achin, our cousin Johnson Achin, he's there for all our special occasions. Thanks again to conduct this wedding. I think this is the first wedding you conducted for our, because he did a lot of baptism for our kids. So, oh, that's a Jewish wedding, yeah. Sorry, I missed that. Yeah, and thank you, Shivu Achin, for coming and joining us here in our this blessed day here being part of this clergy crew. And thank you again on behalf of both our families, like, you know, for everyone joining us here. It was such a short notice. We had to change this church, but it worked out well. And thank you, everyone, for being here for celebrating this glorious occasion. And thank you to our church committee members, and especially to Joby to coordinate this last minute change and approving and helping us out. And all the church members, everyone outside and inside, like, you know, coming in and chipping in to help conduct this wedding here in that short notice. And at this time, like, you know, we a request after the wedding procession is completed, like, we request everyone to go to the Westmount Country Club That's at 728 Rifle Camp Road, Woodland Park, New Jersey. It's about half an hour or maybe 40 minutes from here, not even that much. Please head there. The reception will start at 6 o'clock, and I request all our immediate family members to stay back for some pictures. And the altar boys, sorry. Thank you for the wonderful choir group to come here and making this clip.
Storing all you make, spring. My name is MC Prub, rocking alongside my DJ for the evening, DJ Chaco Flames, and we go by the name of DJ TM. So I want to see who's here ready to party. I want to gauge the energy in the room, so on the count of three, I need you to make some noise. 1, 2, 3! Okay, I think we got a little bit more. On the count of three, I need you guys to make some noise. 1, 2, 3, let's hear it! That's what I'm talking about. I need you guys to keep that energy alive as we welcome. First up, make some noise. Please welcome the groom's parents, Dr. Thomas and Mrs. Anita Koshi. Okay, let's hear it for Mr. and Mrs. Koshi. Next up, make some noise for the bride.
Next, we have Sunita and Jerris Vortis!
out of your seats. Please grab your napkins and wave them in the air. As we get ready to welcome our bride and groom, once again, grab those napkins and wave them in the sky. Please help me welcome the modern day Maharaja alongside his Maharani. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for your bride and groom of the evening. Sumitha and Arun.
Congratulate Arun and Smita for the wonderful blessing you have today. God made both of you together today by the holy matrimony. And God bless you. I remember many years ago, 1984. The date, I cannot forget, maybe she forgot already. Because the day she was baptized by me. I'm so proud of standing here today to witness and celebrate the holy matrimony of my own baptized girl. I thank God for that blessing. I know many of the priests won't get that kind of a blessing. I'm extremely blessed by kind of a special blessing from God. So I'm here to have a word of prayer before we start the function. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this blessed evening. We celebrate the wedding of thy children, Arun and Smita. Dear Lord, it's by your providence that they are united together in the holy matrimony. Family is your gift in our life to cherish each other in happiness and love by the invisible grace bestowed upon us. Give thy grace upon these newly married couples. Grow in mutual trust and love, kindled by the power of Holy Spirit. Make them ideal partners in sharing the family responsibility towards each other and caring for others. Make them ideal parents to bring up their children in spiritual guidance and knowledge. Be with them and shower the blessings upon them abundantly. We pray for everyone gathered here, the guests, the host, the young and the old, including the family of the bride and the bridegroom, the siblings and all the extended family members, and all the relatives. Send the blessings upon them, upon each one of us gathered here. We ask Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you very much, Reverend Father Bubba Matthew. At this time, I'd like to welcome Smita's brother. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Suno Madan.
Hello, everyone. I would like to welcome you all here today to the wedding reception of Arun and Smita. For those of you who don't know me, I am Smita's brother, Sunil. On behalf of my parents, Sayabonda and Mariano Matai, and our entire family, we would like to thank you all for coming and participating in this joyous occasion. Today we are celebrating the wedding of my sister Smita and my new brother-in-law Thomas, more popularly known as Baby and Arun. I would like to say thank you to all the family and friends who have come here internationally and domestically from various areas of the United States. I would also like to take this time to thank all the clergy who took part in the wedding service this afternoon at St. Stephen's Orthodox Church, Midland Park. Reverend Father Thomas Paul, our cousin from St. Basil's, Long Island, New York. Reverend Father Babu K. Matthew, our vicar from St. Stephen's, Midland Park, New Jersey. And the Reverend Father Shibu Daniel from St. Thomas, Dover, New Jersey. Lastly, thank you to the Westmount Country Club for hosting. Hope all you guys have a great time celebrating and enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Sunil. One more time, let's hear it for Sunil.
Listening to
At this time, I'd like to welcome Anita Koshi and Mariama Matai for the milk ceremony. Once again, I'd like to welcome Anita Koshi and Mariama Matai.
Oh,
these lovely seats on the dance floor. Once again, let's hear it for Sunita Margis.
There's a lot of people here. Good evening, everyone. I actually memorized the speech, but since there's so many of you, I have to read off sometimes. So, for whoever does not know me, I am the sister of the bride, Sunita Margis. I am so excited to be standing up here as the matron of honor. The first part of my speech is dedicated to two amazing people, my parents. Mr. Tayo Parmil Matai, also known as TV, and Mariama Matai, known as Mariakuti. From the words of a wonderful man named Martin Luther King, this is for you, Papa and Mommy. Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, free at last. My parents, along with all of us, have been waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting for this day to come. And finally, it's here. We waited so long that my daughter, Alyssa, she was supposed to be a flower girl, turned into a bridesmaid. And my son, who was supposed to be a ring boy, turned into a ring man, or ring bearer, if you could call that. So, but I must say, all this waiting was definitely worth the wait. She was determined. She was so determined to find her perfect match, and she finally did in Arun. So thank you, Arun, for coming into our family. Now, since I embarrassed baby to the minimum, let me tell you some good things about my younger sister. She was a really good kid growing up. She never did anything wrong, to be honest. She was a great student, even got a full scholarship to college. Unlike myself and my brother, who looked for my father for a scholarship. She is very family oriented. We're always in each other's business, so good luck, Arun, to that. So now to a little topic that I hate talking about, but I think it's the right opportunity to do. Baby has supported me through one of the toughest times in my life. Right. I know most of you know that I went through a tough ordeal a year and a half ago. She was always helping me out with the kids, with doctor's appointments, and just with everything, along with my husband, my family, and baby, and my friend. I am standing here today being the matron of honor. So again, thank you, baby. Now, since I embarrassed myself and baby, let me tell you some things about my younger sister. Sorry, hold on. I wish you and Arun a world of happiness and love, and God bless you both. So for the toast part, I am going to leave it up to the man. But I still want to serenade you, baby, and my new brother-in-law with a song, since you love songs so much. So this is for you both. Got you, baby. So embarrassing. Enda meda jimmy ki kammal, enda pen kattundu poi, enda pen rani kumpi, enda pen. Forget this, hit it, DJ!
Enda mele chukki kamal, enda mele kattu kuri, enda mele kattu kuri, enda mele chukki kamal,
All right, let's do this. First of all, ladies, make some noise. Let's hear it. Let's get excited. Put those hands in the air. That's what I'm talking about. All right, Samantha, let's do this, brother. Here we go. On the count of three, 1, 2, 3. Out. Got it. Come closer. Come closer. All right, let's do it here. On the count of three. Ladies, wave those hands in the air. Put them up. Wave them in the air. Samantha, 1, 2, 3. Yes. Somebody's got to go get it. You guys are more shy than I thought.
Well, well, well. I've been waiting 20 years to be able to give a speech for Arun. So where do we begin with the modern day Maharaja? For many of us that immigrated to the US and came here as first generation or second generation, weddings are where worlds collide. You've worked really hard to separate out your family, your friends, and your coworkers. All of them come together for a wedding with completely different views of who Arun is. So let me give you a little view into what I saw. Arun came to the US in 1998. I still remember going to the airport and picking him up, him coming through the doors, tired after 24 hours on a flight. We'd been close as cousins at 6 and 7 years old. And even without anything else, we were just very, very close. In 1998, when we picked him up, I had no idea that a simple event would be so influential. See, what Arun is 1 year younger than me. And as my mom and dad will tell you, between me and my brother, we have 10 years between us. And I never knew I needed a younger brother until I had Arun. So Arun comes through those doors at the airport, and I realize that I have my sidekick. Me as Batman, my Robin. Me as Hulk Hogan, my Macho Man. Me as Sherlock Holmes and my Watson. I was wrong. So, let me say how I was wrong. So, Arun comes and joins high school. High school is some of the hardest years that all of us have is in high school. And he comes not with just one name as Thomas. He comes with Arun Thomas Koshy. And some of his high school friends are here. They'll tell you that students called him everything. From Arun, Thomas, to Koshy. But I always remember that the first couple days since I had been there before he got there, they started calling him Varghese. So Arun, never one to take something lying down, said, "My name is not Varghese, my name is Thomas." So everybody in the school changed his name to, "My name is not Varghese, my name is Thomas." And he became a phrase overnight. Fine. I told him to stay out of my way, right? I was the older brother. Do not talk to me in the hallways. Don't look at me. Just keep walking when you see me. And so many of you guys probably remember from high school, the prom, right? I know all the guys here can totally relate around prom time. The nervousness that we have in trying to meet somebody, talk to somebody. So I'm there, I'm prepping Arun. So I tell Arun, I was like, "So which girl do you like?" I was like, "Let's talk it through." We go through it, we practice it. Arun asked me to the prom. We did a lot of run-throughs, what would happen if somebody said no, somebody said yes, what would we do? But then something weird happened. We come to 2 months before the prom, and each day, Arun comes with a new story. See, each day, Arun had a new girl asking Arun to the prom. So all that coaching that I had done to show him how to talk to a girl, those girls were trying to figure out how to talk to him. Fine, maybe that was an anomaly, just a one-off, right? He's the new kid, he's not from here. They want to talk to him, they want to take him, they like Arun. So Arun gets ready for the prom. So we go through, we teach him dance moves, all that. They're all retired now, which is why you saw me dance the way that I did. The day after prom, Arun comes in with a big smile on his face. It's the next morning. Big smile on his face. I said, "What happened?" He said, "I am the prom king." I was like, wait. You're a candidate for prom king. You were one of the many that was asked, maybe you'll be prom king. He said, "No, I am the prom king." Fine. You can ask my parents. They'll tell you I was jealous. I was not, okay? I was always supportive of my younger brother. I told my mom, this is just in high school. Wait till he gets outside of here. I was like, everybody loves high school. Wait till he gets outside. It's not gonna be like that. Fast forward 2 more years. Arun is a senior in high school. Sorry, 1 more year. Arun is a senior in high school, and Arun decides to come visit me and my friends at college. Me and my friends were like, oh, my little brother's coming. We're gonna take him out. We're gonna have a good time. So a group of us get ready. We take our nicest shirts out, our nicest jeans, and we take Arun. We get to the bar, we get to this restaurant and the bar, and we see some girls, and we're like, okay, we're gonna talk to these girls, we're gonna show Arun how this is done. So we walk over, talking to these girls, 1 hour passes, 2 hour passes, no one is getting anywhere. At 2 hours, we were like, okay, Arun, it's just a bad night. Just a bad night. It's not a good night for us. I was like, let's get ready, we can go. So we start paying. We start paying our tab. The next thing that happens, we always talk about between me and my friends. I don't know if Arun remembers this story. So a girl walks by, and she drops her glasses. So all of us are on the floor, right? Me and all my friends are on the floor trying to find this girl's glasses. We finally have an in. So we're trying to find this girl's glasses. 2 seconds later, 3 things happen. 1, Arun's hand with the glasses up in the air, all of us watching. 2, Arun being escorted to VIP inside the restaurant. 3, Arun waving from VIP to us in the back. That's only a small selection of the stories that have to do with Arun. But, like I said, wedding speeches often talk about how proud brothers are of who their siblings have become. And as I said earlier, weddings bring together different worlds of people, from your families to your coworkers to your friends. And each one of those people, each one of those groups of people sees a different side of you. What I'm proud of Arun has been actually that same kid that we picked up in 1998 is still the same kid that's here today. That boy became a man, but still with the same heart. And that actually people are attracted to him rather than any of the words that come out of his mouth. He defied all the rules, right? We tried to make him cool, we gave him advice, none of it worked, he stuck with his own, and he showed me and everybody else how to be cool. So I'm so proud to share my younger brother, our only prom king in the Abraham entire Koshi family, Arun Koshi, the modern day Maharaja who has finally found his forever Maharani. So if you'll all raise your glasses as we wish a toast to the modern day Maharaja finally finding his forever Maharani, Arun and Smita. Cheers, guys. Cheers.
Some noise for the list of artists and friends.